This is panel. Hello, hello. This is panelogy number 3 by Earl Grey. The best trades of 2013. At first, I want to do some honorable mentions. There is the volume 1 of the library edition of Fear Agent, put out by Dark Horse. Volume 2 will follow in spring 2014. And there are two books that would have made it much higher in my list if there weren't just trade paperbacks. There are Love and Rockets, The Hernandez Brothers, New Stories number 6, and kudos to Comic Crack, Very Casual by Michael DeForge, published by Koyama Press. And I have to apologize and to say that it's certainly unfair to judge an underground product like Very Casual by its production value, because it's printed very well, and I'm glad that there is such a book at all. I can't praise this high enough. Those underground book makers are heroes in a way. But yeah, anyway, I put out this criteria, lay it out for me to make this list, and you will see, you will get what I mean if I go on. So, rank 10 is The Sixth Gun by Colin Bunn and Brian Hurt. The latter is the artist, and it's a spectacular book. Oversized, printed in Mutti, lots of bonus material. And you have ghosts, you have cowboys, you have monsters. It's very entertaining. I have very much laughs and wow moments in this book. That said, it's certainly a conventional story, and if this book wouldn't be this book, I maybe wouldn't have read it at all. A great book, and it was recommended by we have YouTube by a great guy called Captain Strangelife. I think everybody knows Captain Strangelife, so I don't have to say another word about his amazing videos, which are very entertaining and fun. Okay, rank 9. A book that's so beautiful in his retro style that I don't find words to say how good it is. You can rip out nearly every page and frame it and hang it on your wall and praise to the comic god that there is someone like Francesco Francavilla. Oh no, that's not right. Francesco Francavilla maybe is the comic god. I don't know. And I don't want to rip this book anyway. Maybe buy a second one and then... No. Great book, great art. Although it's only fair to say that the story can't live up to its art. The story is more or less just a vehicle for the drawings of Francesco Francavilla and his overwhelming colors, which he did himself too. On rank 8, we have the last volume of Sweet Tooth, which came out this year. Wrote and drawn by this guy, Jeff Lemire, who did lots of wonderful things in the year 2013. And what can I say without spoiling the story? It's very emotionally gripping, and I shed a few tears, I must say, at the end of the story. The tough guy that I am, but on position number 7, there's Wonder Woman. The hardcover trade paperback, volume 3, Iron. Although it kind of annoys me how DC does his hardcovers. They are not bound, they are just glued together and with some double page spreads. You have lots of gutter loss in the middle, and that's not nice, DC. Come on, you can do it better. But it's more than overcompensated by this great, great story arc by Brian Azzarello and the art of Cliff Chiang, and the way they play with the Greek mythology and put this modern version out. It's worth really another episode of Panology, which I will do in the future. And so we go on to Batman, Death of the Family, written by Scott Snyder and drawn by Greg Capullo. And the hardcover glued trade is an example of a gimmick done good, because you can skin the Joker by yourself. The jacket is partially transparent, and you can put it off, and then the gruesome face of Joker without his skin comes, can be seen, and it's really horrible. And together with some art inside, I really don't think that this book is something for children. For an example, I asked my elder son, which turns 14 in some days, if he wants to read this, and he I did it as some kind of warning and showed it to you and to him, and he looks at it shortly and said, "Oh no, Papa, must not be. Maybe sometime in the future." And I can understand why he doesn't want to read this. But it's great. A great horror, shocking book anyway. Next in line, we have Mind Management on place 5. Written and drawn by the prolific Matt Kind. The second volume did come out also, but I haven't read it yet. So I I'm staying with this. And it's a great book in its undergroundy style, very own individual drawing style. Not too complex in its making, but very with a very complex and story with multiple levels of seeing this, and you can read it multiple times and always get another story. And the book in itself is printed very well on thick yellowish paper, which fits to the story, and yes, nice. I really want to read the second volume in the next days. So go on, and we go on to a book which is really horror and really frightening, Revival by Tim Seeley and Mike Norton. And I certainly will do a short Panelogy episode with this one too. And so without further ado, I want to go to place number 3, and this is Hellboy, volume 6. And usually an Hellboy edition must make the first place in my list. And so you can see that there are some other spectacular books must have come out in this year, and they did. Duncan Figredo apes in this book a little, more than just a little, the style of Mike Mignola, to a point on some pages. I think maybe he's the better Mike Mignola. No, I don't think so, because the original is always the better one. And I, in some kind of way, I would have preferred if Mr. Figredo had tried more his own style than to mimic Mike Mignola's. But anyway, there are lots of great pages by other artists in this book. Richard Corben, for an example. Okay, place 2. I would never have thought that a book published by Marvel could be that high in my list. But anyway, here it is. Hawkeye by Matt Fraction and David Aja. It's a wonderful story, really good art, and the deluxe hardcover oversized edition takes this some level higher, because it's really a work of art now, like I think. And just the chapter with the pizza dog is hilarious. And the best trade which came out in 2013, in my opinion, is the best of Milligan and McCarthy, another book published by Dark Horse. and it's a collection of old stories from end of the 70s until mid of the 90s, I guess. Mainly 80s stuff. Okay, you might say old fart stuff. Okay, I'm an old fart too. But looking at this book, I think old farts will never die. It's so colorful, and the color seems to drip off every page, and the pictures I took are really random because every double page is a real joy to look at, and this British art, comic artists are phenomenal, and I can't believe that I have never heard until recently of them. Maybe I remember to have seen an advertisement for one of the books, one of the stories, a long, long time ago, but I never read one of this crazy, over-the-top, fantastic, punkish stories. Actually, this book is too much. I can't read more than a few pages at one sitting, because it's nearly drug abuse. Yeah, your mind starts to spin if you dwell over these pages. Okay. Maybe you tell me what traits did you like most 2013, as YouTubers used to say in the commentaries below. Thank you for listening and watching. Till next time. Bye.